Hi again, Yasper here from the payroll support team. In this video, we're going to run through how to tackle some of the common leave processes using MYOB Essentials. For a rundown on the concepts behind these processes, check out the video at this website. For this demo, we're going to be paying three employees over the Christmas period. The first employee is Tom, who works 40 hours a week. Tom's decided to take the entire period off, which includes annual leave and public holidays. So let's take a look at how we process this in MYOB Essentials. I've already selected our three employees for this pay, so I'll click Start Pay Run. The first thing I'll do is make sure I select Tom. So I'll click Next Employee at the bottom here until Tom is highlighted. Tom isn't working any normal hours, so I'll put 0 in here. Now I click here to add his holiday or leave. A window pops up, which is really helpful because it's asking us what we want to do. Tom's going to be taking annual leave. Notice it shows how much leave he has available. When we click annual leave, we see the annual leave rate calculation. Notice here you've got ordinary weekly pay and average weekly earnings. The software automatically decides which is the highest of the two and puts a little green tick beside it. So in our example today, ordinary weekly pay is the highest. Remember, ordinary weekly pay includes everything the employee would normally get. Now I'll click Save. Then I'll go back to add holidays or leave. And this time I'll click Public Holiday. In here, we're going to enter 16 hours for the 2 days. Then you need to select an hourly rate. Typically, this is based on the relevant daily pay, which is automatically selected. You might decide to use average daily pay if it's not possible to work out the relevant daily pay. Remember, that relevant daily pay is what they would have received had they come to work that day. And let's click Save. I'll enter 24 hours against annual leave, which together with Tom's 16 hours of public holiday, gives us his 40-hour working week. Now let's take a look at Clear. I'll click Previous Employee until Clear is highlighted. Clear is also a full-time employee who works 40 hours. She'll be working through the entire Christmas period, so we'll look at processing her normal hours, as well as some public holidays, where she's entitled to time and a half and 2 alternative holiday days. So let's have a look at how we do that. The first thing I'll do here is enter her normal hours, which in this example is 24. Then I'll click Add Holidays or Leave. You'll notice there's an option here for Public Holiday Worked, which I'll click. In the calculator, I need to enter the number of hours leave and the number of days it represents. So in this case, I'll enter 16 hours and 2 days. Notice the hourly rate is once again based on relevant daily pay, which is now multiplying at 1.5 because of the time and a half. So I'm going to click Save. As you can see, the public holidays have been added and Clear's pay is now done. Lastly, let's select our third employee, Sally. Sally is a part-time employee who works 20 hours a week. One of those days falls on a public holiday which she had off work, and the rest of the time she's going to take as leave in advance. This is how we'd process Sally's pay. First, we'll change her normal hours to 0. Then we'll click Add Holidays or Leave. Then we'll click Public Holiday for the day she didn't work. Because she only works 5 hours per day, I'll enter 5 hours over 1 day. Also notice that relevant daily pay is selected, so we'll click Save. The other part of her pay is the leave in advance, so we'll click Add Holidays or Leave, then click Annual Leave, even though she has no annual leave hours available. It has selected the highest rate again for me, which in this case is your ordinary weekly pay. So I'll just click Save. Now I'm going to enter the number of hours, which for this example is 15. And that makes up Sally's 20 hours. So now we can save this pay run. And that's it done. You can now go through and complete your pay run process as normal. Let's take a look at paying bonuses. Here are the two most common types of bonus. The first is a regular bonus, which is paid periodically and is taxed as normal earnings for the pay period it belongs in. These are usually set as commissions in Essentials. This bonus affects holiday pay accrual and KiwiSaver, as well as annual leave rates. This bonus increases holiday pay by 8% of the bonus amount, as well as being included in average and ordinary weekly rate calculations for annual leave. Then there's a one-off bonus. This bonus is taxed as a lump sum payment. This type of bonus affects your holiday pay accrual and KiwiSaver calculations. However, it only affects the average weekly earnings calculation when it comes to annual leave. If you happen to make a mistake processing any of these in Essentials, don't panic. While you can't edit a whole pay run in Essentials, you can delete a pay for a particular employee from their pay history tab, then re-enter a pay run for them.
Okay, that's it for me. If you want to find out more on how to manage leave in your software, check out our online help. Thanks for watching.